New questions this morning about what the vice president knew. What did Mike Pence know about what Michael Flynn was discussing with the Russian ambassador? And when did he know it? The Russia investigation testing the vice president's in the dark defense. Joining us now is CNN legal and national security analyst Asha Rangappa. She's a former FBI agent. She lectures on this stuff at Yale University. So this is going to be a good testing session. The word from the White House, from the vice president's team, is, I didn't know. And I asked Flynn, and he lied to me. So I went on TV and I repeated lies, and he wound up being dismissed as a result. Good enough?
It's sounding very suspicious. So, Chris, I would say if you look at the timeline where these things are happening, you have the sanctions conversation at the end of December. The FBI interviews Flynn close to the end of January. And very soon after that, Sally Yates, the acting attorney general at the time, comes and talks to him again and basically tells him that this is a problematic situation. So the question is, did Pence know prior to even that conversation and when he was talking about this that Flynn had had these conversations? And here's why it's problematic either way. The administration has said that these sanctions conversations were a matter of normal incoming transition policy. Okay, if that's true, Vice President Pence was the head of the transition team, and he's the incoming vice president. So you would think he would know about policy discussions taking place. So if he didn't know, then something about those conversations, if he was kept in the dark, something about those conversations was just not right.
Okay, and the cause, the basis for suspicion seems to be, you know, correct the assertion, but then evaluate it as well, please, which is, it seems that Flynn was talking about what he was doing in terms of discussing sanctions, et cetera, with other members of the team. There are emails to this effect. So, at a minimum, that moves away the speculation that he was someone who went rogue, who was an outlier. And it also adds to the suspicion that, well, if all these people knew, and this was going on during the transition, how did the head of the transition not know?
Exactly. So we know that in the pleading documents, that the statement of offense that Flynn pleaded guilty to, which means that these are facts that Mueller can actually prove, that he was in communication with senior transition officials. And exactly like you said, Chris, if he's in contact with senior transition officials about, you know, policy decisions, how can the head of the transition team not know? And if they were keeping him in the dark, why?
Right. And then my favorite question. So what? What if he, you know, if, so what? He should have known. He didn't know. Maybe it goes to incompetence. Maybe it goes to poor communication. Maybe it goes to dislocation. They were doing a lot of this out of New York and he was in Washington, D.C. Trump's people didn't want to talk to Pence's people. Whatever it is, I don't know if any of that's true, but no matter what the reason is, so what? How does this become something that's a matter for Mueller?
It becomes a matter for Mueller because, again, if this is true that Vice President Pence didn't know, and this is all happening in some cabal of people underneath him, you know, this is starting to form, that makes it less ordinary. And we don't know yet exactly what that conduct was, but we do know that Sally Yates described it to McGahn as being incredibly problematic and something that Flynn could be blackmailed about, and that she actually took the step of going to the White House. So I think that there's clearly something there that was alarming enough for Sally Yates to go. And I think that is what Mueller's going to focus on and how many people were involved in that activity.
Don Jr. going in to talk today. Supposedly the focus will be what happened at that meeting with the lawyer who said she had dirt on Hillary Clinton. What's the plus minus there? What are the pitfalls? What are the potential advantages?
Well, he's going to have to explain himself once again. You know, we're seeing this pattern where Don Jr. is kind of consistently very eager to receive dirt on Hillary Clinton. And so it's getting more and more implausible that these are just accidental things that were not being solicited or that, you know, didn't go anywhere potentially. So
how about the so what on that? You know, let's say it is what people want it to be, who are concerned about it. So it was, he wanted dirt on Clinton, she promised it, and then she ran some game on him in the meeting and wound up using it as a bait and switch to talk about some other agenda. So what? Where's the crime in that?
Well, we don't know what the crime is yet, if there is one. There may not be one, Chris. Mm-hmm. So here is the actual truth. Like, let's get down and dirty on this. Collusion is a descriptive term to describe a criminal act called conspiracy, okay? Mm-hmm. A conspiracy is an agreement to commit a crime. So you can start to see the elements of maybe an agreement, but you still need a crime underneath it. And I think that is going to be the problematic piece in terms of, you know, what is Mueller going to find there? So, you know, this may not be a chargeable thing, but it's whether or not there was some kind of quid pro quo going on.
May not be something for Mueller, but it could be something that politicians could go to town on if they have the votes. Asha Rangappa, thank you very much, as always.
Thank you.